Sure.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, so for this episode of Sundays with Suraj, we have Sunil and Syed back with us here again. Previously we had him here, and I missed him because he's a very busy man.
Yeah.
Apparently, I don't know how true is that, or he's just avoiding me.
Why would anyone avoid you, bro?
This is sweet, man. Okay, so they started something called Chill Sesh Live. I honestly don't know much about it too. However, I'm the sustainability partner to Make the Garden. So I have a lot of doubts. So let's get that sorted.
Yeah.
What is Chill Sesh Live?
First of all, it's Chill Sesh.
Be louder.
First of all, it's Chill Sesh.
Then why do you have live?
We couldn't get the handle, Chill Sesh handle. So we like...
Okay.
It's always about that. A lot of people still address our business, like the actual business, as Hustling Global, when it's actually Hustling Media.
Really?
Yeah,
I didn't know that
media.
Too.
It's not Hustling Global. And a lot of people add the G with Hustling.
Right.
Just Hustling.
Yeah. I did that too. I am that lot of people.
That's really cool.
Chill Sesh is a property that we wanted to do for like a year now.
Mm-hmm.
Our idea was very simple. We just wanted to create intimate, hyper-local experiences,
okay,
which were not like particular to one specific topic. So, mm-hmm, if you see, we are doing Chill Sesh Socials this month.
Mm-hmm.
Socials is all about having fun, having like networking with people, chilling around.
Right.
We have other things planned also, like a super car meetup or like a coffee tasting session. So it's altogether, it's a property just to create intimate and hyper-local experiences, which focuses on networking and collaboration while experiencing something new that you've not done in time before.
Right.
So that's Chill Sesh as a...
How did you guys, you know, come up with this entire concept? Because to be honest, this is the first time even I am hearing about. That is why I am personally super excited. No clue how it's going to be, but super excited.
See, we never wanted to have huge events,
mm-hmm,
right? Like, we've been a part of a lot of huge events where,
right,
there were like attendees, about 15,000 attendees, 18,000 attendees.
Damn.
Like, that was the scale of, you know, events that we're looking at. Uh-huh. And then we were like, hey, the experience is great from a bird's eye view. But when you look at it from an attendee view, I don't think everyone's getting to experience everything. I don't think everyone's getting the value for the buck.
Right.
Which is when we were like, we should build hyper-local experiences. We should build experiences where we know everyone and everyone knows who we are, and we should do it at a global scale.
Right.
Right. So any city in this world should be able to host a Chill Sesh for their people.
Mm-hmm.
And this experience should be very micro, very intimate, so that at the end of the day, everyone knows everyone when they leave the venue.
Right.
Right. Or everyone at least can recognize them by face, at the least.
Building a small community type.
Exactly. And if that happens with the network effect, a lot of people want to come in. And then we're looking at building this whole concept of scarcity era, memberships, you know, all of the whole place where we get to pick if you can attend the event or not.
Right.
Right. But that's a very far-fetched idea, and we hope it gets there. Right. Because that's when membership, that's when it becomes like a private club sort of thing, but globally.
Man, I love that vision, man. I love the reason I love having this podcast is you guys don't think at a normal level, and I always resonate with people who always think outside the box and not just outside, 10 times higher.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So that's the plan, man. That's the plan. And like Muzamil mentioned, right? Like, it's hyperlocal experiences. So in New York, if you're doing this event in New York, we could have a bagel making session. We could have a session where you are have a dollar pizza store, right? Dollar pizzas are extremely popular in New York. So a dollar pizza store can be hosting a Chill Sesh where they take 15 people into their kitchen and show them how a dollar pizza is made.
Right.
Right. But at the same time, you can never recreate that concept anywhere in the world.
True.
Right? So that's the kind of concept we're looking at building the Chill Sesh. So if you actually want to be a part of it, and just because you have the Chill Sesh branding property and you've experienced Chill Sesh in Bangalore, you'll actually fly from Bangalore to New York to actually experience that because you have access to it.
That's interesting, man.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the...
That's really far thought, but
yeah. Yeah.
That's still very interesting.
Yeah.
If you understood what he meant by that, you'd get a gist of what he's saying.
Yeah.
It's not just...
Chills, bro.
Chills, bro. So, If I were to come to Chill Sesh Live, sorry, Chill Sesh.
This event is called Chill Sesh Socials.
Chill Sesh Socials.
Yeah.
What can I expect there?
So first of all, you can expect a very very chill vibe.
Of course.
But specifically for this event, we wanted to make it super tight and like an experience where people are not that alien to the concept, plus also they are like getting to know something while being at that event. So we got musicians, we got stand-up. So musicians, maybe our lineup is not completely alien to people, but there are a few people who have not been recognized for a lot of years, right? So there are new people and also like people who have been doing this for a lot of years.
Could you give me a few names?
Yeah, so if you say Yashwant Nag, he is a part of this whole band called Chaurasta, which is huge in Hyderabad. Around, right? So we got him and people are like crazy about the whole band and the songs that they release and like, you know, the way they are
So what we're doing really is we are engineering familiarity and then we're bringing in newness to the same concept. So familiarity comes in when you bring in an artist like Yashwant Nag, like Nitish, because a lot of people already know them, right? But at the same time, you're bringing in someone as young and as talented as them, like Aditi Apraj. Now, a lot of people don't know Aditi, but she's equally extremely well talented, right? And we want to introduce that Nitish
underground talent,
exactly,
as they claim it.
Exactly. Yeah. And what's really interesting about what we're building with Chilsa Socials is the fact that almost all the businesses that we're working with to making this event happen, all of them are like founders of these businesses are all below 25.
Nice.
All of them are below 25.
Yeah.
Who all?
You and like the people who run Purple Solace, the people who run Creators Exchange, Refined, Lost Sock.
So this is something like young,
this is super young,
young
super
audience trying to do shit in their lives.
Yeah.
Coming together.
Yeah.
See,
I love
we
that.
Always envision a community, right?
Right?
But nobody actually puts in the effort to build the community. They always want to build themselves.
Yeah.
But I think we are taking the first step in building the community first and then looking at building assets in the process.
I think that's the game of a legacy type, you could say, because a community which stays together that always goes forward together too.
And talking about this point of, you know, bringing the community together, we have seen multiple huge brands who are like, you know, who make these large festivals, youth festivals and like events that are about youth and all of that, come to Hyderabad but fail like tremendously because the people here are like really not into events where they can learn or experience something new. It's all about either you go to a concert or like a pub or something,
right,
and then just chill around with people. But we thought, so what we understood there, because we have been closely related to those, you know, events and organizations, we understood that there is no one recognition or an umbrella under where like everyone who's doing anything in the city are like known. So if you take for an example, Siddharth Bendi, he runs a Creators Exchange online and he's a great musician. He, for him to network with someone in Hyderabad, like if he wants to find out a person like you who is a digital marketer, there has to be a platform where they come together, like they come together and they speak and like there is something happening. And if people like you and him and like other people from different parts, even if they know each other, they can do something very substantial in the future and the whole culture of the city can change and like organizations and companies can look at this city and not be like, okay, this is just a city, just wants to laze around and party and just like that.
See, what's interesting is, I wouldn't call the city lazing around and partying all the time, but what's interesting is, I've seen event companies work in Bombay, Bangalore, Delhi, Chennai also, but they are very hesitant to come to Hyderabad, right?
Hyderabad's crowd is pretty unpredictable, huh?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So what's interesting is, I don't know if this is 2016 or 17, but NH7 Weekender had to happen in Hyderabad.
Okay. I don't know what that is, but
NH7 Weekend is India's biggest music festival.
Okay.
Right? It has some of the best artists from all over the world coming down to Pune and Shillong.
Okay.
And perform in December.
All independent artists.
All independent artists, like beautiful fucking fest. And they had to come to Hyderabad, as one of their leg was Hyderabad. And they just couldn't pull it off here because they were just not able to push. There was no ecosystem here. Like if you go to Bombay, there is an ecosystem that can push sales.
Right.
And if you go to Shillong has so much of underground music culture that you just put up a banner somewhere in some corner, people still buy tickets. But in Hyderabad, Hyderabad there's nothing like that, dude. Hyderabad people will book a ticket 3 hours before the event. Right?
Hyderabad is that kind of like
that. Yeah. So we're precisely trying to change that culture. And you know, what's very interesting about socials and why we picked that as our first event is because we realized that building conversation in Hyderabad is very difficult.
How do you mean?
It's if you're a college student and you're in a club, it's very difficult for you to open a new conversation with a random stranger.
Okay.
It is. Yeah. When you compare it to a different city like a Bombay or a Bangalore, it is. Because yahan pe the culture and the demographic of people is not filled with people of our age. Concentration of our age group is very less. It's okay. All very diversified. Right? So if you take a city like Bangalore, there is Joseph's, there is Bishop's, there is Christ, there is SPJ, there are like five other colleges.
Oh shit, you're talking about colleges. When you mentioned all for a second, I was like, is this dude mentioning religions here?
My point being, you will find those groups of people.
Right.
Here you don't.
Here I mean, you have CBITNs, they have their own shit there, right?
But you know what CBITNs and like, or IITNs or whatever it is, do at their leisure time or like, they don't even know half of the college.
True.
So that's the problem. There's no campus culture here to start off with.
Right.
Forget about culture outside. There's no campus culture to start off with.
The interesting part is the peak that you get in the campus culture is a DJ night.
Is a DJ night.
It's a DJ night.
That's so true, man.
And
that's
like,
very
people
true.
Are like really excited to have a DJ night.
A DJ night. And I've seen experiences where I get fucking goosebumps to hear about business fests in colleges because the quality of that festing is so high that you actually feel like you're in a simulation.
Right.
Right. And that's what builds culture, man. And that shit is still very low in Hyderabad. And for whatever reasons, right? I don't want to blame anything or I don't want to, you know, say pointed and say, but for us, we saw a white space there and we are breaking that.
Right.
And since we can't walk into college and say you guys can't do this, so let us do it. We're building it outside colleges. We're building it outside and we're not exactly not looking at colleges as a market. Right? So colleges is a gateway market for us. But at the same time, young employees working in MNCs, young artists, young creatives, this is the market we're looking for. And we are trying to, you know, capitalize on them as much as possible because they are the ones who are pushing this entire new culture forward.
Right.
So we see a lot of potential in the way Hyderabad city can be molded because there are not a lot of players.
Very true, man, because as I mentioned earlier, this is the first time I myself am hearing it within Hyderabad because I've heard something like this happen in Mumbai for sure.
Yep.
My friend was actually telling me something like this. As a matter of fact, somebody from LinkedIn was telling me that soon she will put me in touch with somebody that's basically a group of people who connect once every month. And these people are again individuals from different sectors. They help each other.
Yeah.
Like they come to chill, but during the chilling session, like you get me business, I get you business.
Yeah.
That kind of thing. I feel like this kind of concept
yeah.
would really give that youth who yeah. want to do business and also chill
exactly,
at the same time.
Exactly. See, I am building, I'm being very honest and blunt, I'm building an experience that I want to be a part of.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Yeah. If you don't believe it, like, you wouldn't have that.
Like, as much as I see a market space here, I'm building an experience that I want to be a part of. I want to be a part of an experience where I'm listening to music, but I'm also having a conversation with the person sitting beside me, and who knows, three days down the line, I'm starting a new business with them.
Right.
And for me, it's very important as an organizer to ensure the quality of the audience, to ensure the quality of content and experience.
Right.
Which is why we are so keen on every individual aspect in the event. Right? Right from what is the kind of branding we're looking for, to the kind of businesses we're working with. Right? So I could partner with any company that is selling me paints.
Right.
And make them my mindful painting partner. But why have I collaborated with someone who's just out of college, who's just building a fluid art empire for themselves? Right? Because I understand that they come from a place of grit, and so do we.
Okay.
And they will pull the right crowd for us.
Definitely, I agree. You know, the moment I pitched him that Make Me Garden can come in as the sustainability partner, I was first hesitant because usually people don't pick a partner just for a small save. So you know, when he said yes, this, if you go look at the stats, the shit ton of paper being wasted for events just for inviting people. If you calculate on a year basis, shit ton of paper is being wasted. So you know, when you were like seed paper, yes, seeds, yes, seed bands, yes. I think that was
we basically said fuck off to paper.
Right.
There is no paper that we are using that is going to go into trash can.
True.
Yeah. And the concept also like really was very interesting because we always heard about few products which you know you can put it on the soil and it'll grow and all of that. But having seed paper and then using it for invites, for bands, for different like visiting cards and all of that, like. That was really interesting because you know obviously there is a part of not wasting any paper and like reusing it and also pushing that idea of gardening or like growing something among people. That's also a huge factor. That
think about this, dude. How many events on our scale even think of having a sustainability partner?
Exactly. That is the most exciting thing for me. The reason I was excited was young. Something which is related to young people, there you're gonna promote something related with gardening and environment. Because you know, if you just go out and tell people about grow your own food, they might be like, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
But if they just drop 2-3
seeds in the pocket, be like, now go fucking grow your food. Right?
No, if they just throw it on the soil also, when they get the plant, you need not tell them, go check it out. They'll definitely go keep checking it out. And I think whoever visits that event, they're gonna get nice vegetable seeds, which they can grow and eat. That I can guarantee.
Yeah.
Who knows? 3 months down the line, we'll do chill session, salad session where everyone gets the vegetables.
Fuck yes.
And we make.
Look at this. This is like a pre-chill session where we're discussing all of what he's saying right now in a chill zone.
Yeah.
Talking about business again.
Dude, I really think we should do that. We'll actually try to tie up with a agro farm or a farmhouse sort of a thing, and we'll host the shit.
Definitely, I'm not for it. Let's talk about it.
Yeah, that's gonna be fucking.
Yeah, I mean, all the people who are gonna attend will be like, there's gonna be this in like 3 months. Throw your vegetables and get access.
Yeah.
Free access.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people are now even interested in something like that, growing your own food after this entire pandemic.
You know what I'm more excited about right now? I'm excited about someone to start something similar like us in
Yeah.
It's gonna give you some competition.
Exactly.
It is required actually. Because
it's very important for us. Honestly.
Because if
being super honest.
If there are more than one players doing similar stuff and
got to get better.
No, not to get better, but then if the crowd is able to experience it, they might not come to chill sites, they might come to another property, but they're experiencing the same thing that we want to experience. The culture evolves, and at the end of the day, when all of these people come together and do something big, or like even if we do something very big, people will be accepting to at least read the promotional stuff or like understand the event, and they will be like, okay, I will give a second thought to this to come to this event and buy tickets. So it will help the community.
Yeah, see, it's simple. Our audience are our best judge, right? If there's a competitor who's building a similar experience and they go experience that, they'll know if they are better or we are better.
Until then, Chiltesh is the best.
Buy tickets.
Fingers crossed.
Buy tickets, yes. So, talking about experiential zones, what all experiential zones can one expect at Chiltesh Socials?
So, while we were planning about experience zones, we were very thoughtful in terms of let's not overcrowd all the experience zones. Because we also want them to experience live music and comedy and like have a networking session or talk, speak to people. But also have a zone where it's not a compulsion for you to come and experience it.
Yeah.
Or it doesn't create this thing, FOMO for you to like, okay, I need to go.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a safe space.
But it flows with the event. It flows with the event. So the first thing that we actually finalized was the mindful painting zone.
Okay.
Because we really like the idea of, you know, you are vibing with good music, you are having good food, you have good people around. But you, if you could put out that energy into some form, I think painting was a very good option for us.
I think a lot of people would enjoy, you know, just chilling around and having their own.
The high I want to reach in life is not anything but listen to good music, eat good food and paint. right?
Right.
Because that's like the most visual thing you can build for yourself with your own fucking hands.
Definitely, man. Definitely.
You feel that you've accomplished something, or like, I know personally there are a lot of people who were like great artists and like great painters or whatever it is, like in the school days or like college days, but then life happened and then they are like not doing anything. But then if I'm able to get these people, and I'm pretty sure half of the people who come to the Chill Sesh have that thinking, okay, I want to draw or paint someday.
Definitely.
So if they're able to get that platform there, and I'm personally very excited to like paint there because I am that person. Oh. I really want to like paint and do stuff. So that was one zone that we wanted to keep. And it's very chill. We didn't decide a theme. You have to paint under a theme.
Yeah, there's no theme. Fuck,
whatever you want.
Whatever you're feeling.
Whatever you want.
I want to sit and draw a portrait of you or like paint.
Yeah.
So
I'm gonna pose.
Just go crazy. That's the whole point.
Or like, you know, I wanna paint something and then sell it to someone at the same point.
Damn, that's
that
interesting.
That would be a thing, right?
So, put a hustle there.
Hustle.
Yeah.
And so that was the first zone that we really wanted to have it, and then we have it now. And then the next thing that you can experience is it is more of a collaboration or like meeting new people kind of a zone, which is hosted by Siddharth Painli.
Okay.
So he runs this creators exchange, a community of like creative people
right.
who want to get into the community or like know people who are already creating. So he used to do, he does it on his social media, especially like Instagram. Every Monday he used to like call anyone who wanted to like perform or like display their thing, rappers, musicians or artists. They wanted to like just perform and just show their thing out.
Showcase their talent
and also meet people having the same mindset.
Right.
So he used to do it online. So we thought, why not get that offline? And while we are also calling a lot of influential people and like people who are into all of these things, sit and collaborate, or like even just talk, have a conversation,
right.
or like do a speed networking session.
So we are looking at facilitating the conversation, not forcing it.
Right.
So because we want people to have conversations, but when you say, hey, you know what, take this card, have a speed prompt or whatever, that's when it becomes a place where you're forcing someone to have a conversation. So we're just making sure we're just facilitating the conversation for them. And apart from that, obviously we're building this other experience called a sock party, a lost sock party.
What is that?
No.
Dude, that's something I'm really excited about, because it's this, so we have the entire indoor seating where the live experiences happen. We are not putting chairs.
Okay.
We're putting mattresses.
Interesting.
Alright, and since this whole COVID-19 situation is happening, we want to keep the place extremely clean. Which is why we're asking everyone to leave their footwear at a
I love that, man. I love that.
Alright? And then we put a sock part. We have a sock partner called Lost Sock. So we got them, and their socks are super interesting because they have a magnet in their sock, so you'll never lose your sock.
How do you mean?
So you have, like, both your socks have a magnet inside them.
Okay.
Just stick them together. And you never lose the sock.
Nice.
They're always together.
It always happens, man. I don't know. I throw it for wash and then I get one fucking sock back.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly why we're doing that. And so we're collaborating with them. And you can come in with your own cool sock, or you can buy a sock from them.
Okay.
Right? And then chill in the sock. So we're not expecting people to come in all dressed up and shit, bro. We just want you to like come in like a chill event. Like come in your PJs.
Right.
Right? Just come in your PJs. Have a chill time, get some hot chocolate, get some, you know, whatever, and just relax. You know, that's the kind of vibe we're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one thing. And the last thing, obviously, is not an experience, but we have a stall with Shop Refine.
Right.
Yeah.
So we're looking at, I mean, thrift is the new thing.
Definitely.
So we're looking at pushing that hard.
Mm-hmm.
Again, like, thrifting was a very exciting idea because the idea is very it's all about sustainability.
Yes.
And you know, reusing stuff that you have, and also a lot of people tried doing it but not at the scale of Shop Refine. Like,
exactly,
these people got,
they're going at a small scale within their closet itself.
Yeah.
Not reaching out to anyone who wants to sell.
Exactly. And that we thought would be a great experience, so like we got in touch with them, and like that really worked out. So that's one thing that you can expect from Chill Sesh. And
obviously, like, great fucking music, and also there's a cafe there called I don't know how to spell it, but ZZA Cafe.
Zah.
You can probably just call that.
Yeah.
That's it. Just asking everyone, I don't know how to spell this in ZZA.
It's like Zah, bro.
Zah.
Yeah.
And so it's an Italian cafe.
Okay.
So they have like great pizzas and like pastas and all that. So
I mean, what better thing to chill with than pizzas?
In your PJs, having a sock party.
Basically, the comfort of home with several experiences.
Yeah, like, and all at $4.99, guys. Tickets in linsider.in.
I'll drop the link in the description.
Yeah.
Hey, why are you putting your head down, man?
I don't know. I don't like promoting it this way. But
why? Yeah. That's your own product or service.
Yes, yeah. You should be proud of that.
Yeah,
shit.
I believe in that.
Yeah.
$4.99, get it.
$4.99.
Yes. We'll launch some discounts, but don't wait for them.
Oh yeah, we have some cool things.
Please
in
support mind. Small business, guys.
Yes, bro. Please support small businesses. Anyways, so you'll have around 5 experiential zones, right?
Yeah.
Mm. Apart from that, you're having live music. How many performers?
We have 4 performers confirmed.
Crazy.
But we might have some surprises.
So yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
Okay, after this I'm gonna...
Okay. We might have some surprises.
Yeah.
Okay, and then you have stand-up comedy too.
Yeah.
You didn't talk about that.
Well, you know, we will let Farhan Ahmed talk about it because he has a lot to say.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm super excited for Farhan's performance. At the same time, I'm super excited for Yashwant Nag's performance because Yashwant Nag is gonna like...
Get
and
it.
They're gonna have a new launch of their new song,
yeah,
Chara, so I'm sure he'll perform that also. So we're really excited to receive the set list first and see what they have to perform. But either ways, I think...
It's gonna be a great fucking thing.
Yeah. And see, everyone has something to take away from it, right? Like someone who's into stand-up will fucking blow off with Farhan because Farhan hasn't performed in a lot of places before, so I'm sure he's gonna be a different thing altogether. And Yashwant Nag is Yashwant Nag, obviously. Nitish is gonna do like 90% singles and then, I mean, 90% of his original music and only 10% of covers.
Nice.
And Aditi is gonna do 90% covers and maybe 10% of her own music. So we're balancing out so well on the lineup also, which will be super
and,
cool.
And I'm pretty sure that a lot of cool people are coming to the event.
Yeah.
So, what do you mean by cool people, man?
We have sent out invites
among cool
the
people?
Best.
Of course. Yeah. Cool people, including our partners.
Thank you.
We have sent out invites to some of the best people in the city. And when I say best people...
Give me a few names there.
We've invited the Indian Minimalist, Fernandist.
Vishal Fernandez.
And you've also invited a vegan...
Yeah, that's
vegan
what
blogger. You can't see her, she didn't want to be in the video.
She's the Indian minimalist. So
yeah,
like,
she's the Indian minimalist.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
And we have a bunch of fashion influencers coming in.
Mm-hmm.
A bunch of photographers coming in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A bunch of entrepreneurs who we've invited. Hopefully, who we could work with later in
I'm excited to meet those entrepreneurs now. Get me connected.
Sure. It's all about connecting and meeting people.
Yes.
So like,
Make the most of the Shriyad that you can be there. Like, that's all I'm going to say. For anyone who's going to be there, don't fucking sit there and just listen to music because that's going to play anyway. Right? Just move and meet new people, experience and really show what it means to be in an event which is all for you. Right? Like, none of this experience, like, if you look at any of what we're building here, it's not an our personal gain.
It's for everyone. Whoever is there, they're going to be benefiting.
Exactly. So we're not looking at like selling water bottles and making money on the side or like we're not doing shitty fucking things like that.
We're not even making, so to be very honest, we're not even making a single penny selling the tickets that we are.
Yeah.
Because everything is going in to make the experience as we want.
I kind of guessed it with the costing you put. I kind of guessed that most of your money which is coming in is going to go out for just maintenance.
Guess what? So what's really interesting is, this is not from Chilsa's perspective, but from a Hustle perspective.
Right.
We have built the business in the last 6 months and we've built it tight. Right? So we've built revenue streams that can help us float this experience.
Right.
In the process, build culture. Because at the end of the day, we want to build culture and we've built the business that can back that culture now.
Right, makes sense.
Yeah.
So we're not going blind into this event and say, hey, we have money, we're going to blow it up. We are saying we've made that money so that we can float this experience and in the process also tighten the business at the back end.
And to have a pilot experience that we can pitch it to different people where we can collaborate and like even enhance the experience better.
So it's very simple, go from next time, we are not going to put a single penny from our pockets. And at the same time, we want to make sure that any brand we're working with, they're getting worth every penny that they're putting on a business.
Right.
As simple as that.
I think that's a great plan because around like 3 weeks ago, I had this one beer company who wanted to get tied up with some event, not event management company, but some traditional marketing person who's related to events. So, you know, this kind of concept which you're laying out, I think would roll out perfect.
See,
for somebody to push out a product.
Yeah, absolutely. What's happening is a lot of brands are now spending on experiential marketing.
Right.
And there are not a lot of players, especially in the hyper-local events business,
right,
who are doing experiential marketing. And what's interesting is, for a lot of brands, experiential marketing on the hyper-local terms will get them more conversions.
Definitely, like, even with Make Me Garden, everybody says gardening, and I say fucking experience.
Yeah.
We have a tagline called experiential gardening.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, the whole concept behind it is everybody is already selling everything.
Yeah.
You give them the experience of how it happens from the scratch. Mm. So I think, you know, partnering up with another experiential event would be the right kind of stage for both of us to grow, actually.
Absolutely.
And the people who are attending there are also like that. They understand it.
Right.
And like, it's not like, you know, we are calling random people to attend, but the people who are attending also understand it. So there is very high rate of like conversion or, you know, at least reaching out to the right masses, if I may say. So really hoping that that happens.
So if they have to go check out this, your social media handles, where can they find you?
So on Instagram, we are at chillseshlife. Mm-hmm. That's the handle. And there's also a website, and like we are basically on Instagram right now. So
okay, I'll drop that link in the description.
Yeah.
And about the tickets, I want you to tell me. Come on,
I like that.
Where can I find the tickets?
You can find the tickets at insider.in/chillseshsocials.
Yeah.
Selling for
$4.99.
Go get that. I'll drop that link also in the description.
Yep.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.